Welcome to the show. If you're just joining us, we've got a big hour of television for you. First today, Australians will head to the polls in just 4 days with Scott Morrison and Anthony Albanese in the final leg of the election campaign. Jonathan Kersley is in Perth with Labor. Jono, spending is in the spotlight.
It is. The coalition is clearly trying to set up an economic fight with the Labor Party in the final days of this election campaign, Carl. Later on today, the government will be releasing its policy costings, essentially saying there's been a billion-dollar improvement to the budget bottom line since March. It's been critical of the Labor Party for not releasing details of its plans. Earlier on today on Nine, Shadow Minister Bill Shorten said that will be done on Thursday. That is despite the opposition leader and senior shadow ministers not saying when those policy costing details will be released. Anthony Albanese has also refused to say whether deficits would be higher or lower under the Labor Party than the coalition. This morning, the Australian Financial Review has reported that an elected Labor government could deliver budget deficits $10 to $15 billion higher than that forecast by the coalition. The Prime Minister has been keen to make this an attack line during the course of this week. Here is Shadow Minister Bill Shorten speaking a little earlier.
But I have to say that Mr. Morrison, he's a classic bloke from Marketing 101. He's trying to distract people with Labor. We've been announcing how much our policies cost as they go along.
Last night, the Prime Minister would not be drawn on his political future beyond the election. He will start today in Darwin. Anthony Albanese here in Perth, where in a couple of hours he will address a business leaders' breakfast before jetting off across the country, Carl, because this is the final dash for votes.
Thanks, Jono. Nine News has you covered on election day as well. Tune in from 4 p.m. on the East Coast, 3:30 in South Australia and 2 o'clock in WA.
The large-scale search for an elderly man who disappeared on a walk in Victoria's Alpine region is growing increasingly desperate this morning. Live to Lana Murphy in Dinner Plain, near where he disappeared, Lana, members of the community have spent the night looking for him.
Ali, 150 people are here on the ground doing their best to try and bring Christo home. Last night, there were Victoria Police members roaming in their vehicles with infrared cameras trying to detect any sign of body heat. But this morning, there is still no sign of 70-year-old Christo. The 70-year-old went missing on Friday afternoon at 2:45. He went for a walk right where I'm standing and told his family that he was going to see emus, but he's just spent his fourth night missing in these freezing conditions. It got down to negative 3 degrees with wind gusts of up to 70 kilometres per hour. And hopes are quickly fading. The weather is expected to get worse with snow today. Christo's family released a statement late yesterday saying that they're hoping that the resilient and adventurous grandfather will make his way back to us. He has a loving and resilient spirit. And today, Ali, they are here on the ground in Dinner Plain, willing their grandfather and their father to come home.
OK, thanks, Lana.
A West Australian family is demanding answers this morning after an 80-year-old grandmum died alone while waiting for an ambulance. This is what happened. At 2:30 a.m. on Sunday morning, Georgina Wilde called 000 complaining about chest pains. The job was flagged as priority one, meaning a 15-minute response time. Half an hour later, she was called and told there were no ambulances available. At 3:30, she was told the same thing. At 4 a.m, she didn't answer the phone. Nearly 2.5 hours after her original call, an ambulance arrived and found her dead from a suspected heart attack. Olivia Donaldson is in Perth this morning. Olivia, what does the ambulance service have to say about that?
Carl, St John's says that they are doing everything they can right now, but it's been a particularly tough week for the service. They've issued two public warnings on delays of answering 000 calls as well as ambulances getting to patients on time. But our ambulance service is right now experiencing a 20% staff shortage. One paramedic said in a survey, "I'm ashamed of the organisation and I fear for the public and my family." Here's what St John's CEO Michelle Fife had to say.
Sometimes words are not enough. There are no words that can make this better. There are no words.
Carl, Georgina Wilde was found on her couch with her door unlocked and the television still on, and her family are right now asking how this could have happened.
The pain for them. Olivia, thank you.
A Hollywood heartthrob is heading down under. Who is it? Ryan Gosling. He'll be calling Sydney home temporarily as he shoots a new action film here later in the year. Let's go to Gabrielle Boyle for the details. Gabby, good morning. We need details, and we need the details now.
Well, I am a hard-hitting investigative journalist, and I have spent lots of time on Google Images this morning just to make sure I can bring you all the details, particularly for our female viewers. Ryan Gosling is coming to Sydney, he's coming to New South Wales, and he's coming in the springtime. He's starring in an action film, The Fall Guy. It's basically a new make of an 80s TV series, and he's expected to be here for several months shooting, not only, as I said, in Sydney, but right around regional New South Wales as well. This is good news for the economy, not just the women of Sydney and New South Wales. It's worth about $244 million to the economy. Alex?
Houses. Hubba bubba. Hey, Gabby, thank you so much.
Known to all as one of the best Aussie cricketing all-rounders, but those close to Roy knew him as the bloke who'd always stop, give his time and have a chat. The Townsville local has left a giant hole in the city, and today's Mia Glover found out why he was adored by everyone he met.
He loved his North Queensland community and it loved him right back. The city of Townsville deep in mourning following the shock loss of their beloved Roy.
I think there was many a grown man shedding a few tears. It was just surreal.
Peter says Roy always had time to coach and mentor local kids who dreamed of making it big in cricket, something he cherished.
You could just talk to him about anything, anyone who had any issues or just had a question about cricket.
Adam Edmondson had the honour of training and playing alongside Simo in the Queensland Under-19 squad and at the Wanderers Cricket Club.
You could tell when he was young that he was obviously going to have a bright future with his cricket because, you know, he stood out, you know, above a lot of other you know, kids our age.
But Roy not only loved his cricket, his other love was throwing in a line. Taking his young kids along for a deep sea or creek adventure out of town, posing for picture after picture with his catch.
I think he was big name in fishing.
He was a regular at Higo's bait and tackle shop and always had a smile for staff.
At least seen once a week most times. Always pleasant, you know, easy to get along with. Yeah, really good.
Simo loved his fish so much, he became the ambassador for Mark and Louise's Ingham Road seafood store.
So come on in and tell them Roy sent you.
He quickly became a crowd favourite, serving customers.
Yeah, it was a bit of a nightmare. The Tills and Roy weren't good.
And regularly sent Mark pics of his catch when he was unsure what it was.
And he actually sent me one of a catfish one day and I told him, Roy, don't tell anyone you caught a catfish.
His mates are now pushing for a permanent tribute in Townsville.
Maybe we do need a Andrew Roy Symonds grandstand, who knows?
Already fans are doing what they can to pay tribute. Rods out for Roy, becoming a social media trend, all with the aim of keeping his larrikin spirit alive.
And it's also about when his family's driving around. When Laura's driving around, she can see some support.
True community man, wasn't he? Yeah. And we're pleased to say we're joined now by cricket legend Alan Border. Alan, we appreciate you coming on this morning because we know you knew Andrew on a personal level. It's all pretty tough to take in, isn't it?
It's been an incredible few months, hasn't it, for the game of cricket? Just losing so many quality people far too soon. And just Andrew, I mean, it just has knocked everyone around that I know that knew him, and he's such a great fella, full of life, and it's just so sad the way it's all panned out at the moment. It's just quite an incredible period for us.
Yeah, incredible in the worst possible way, AB. I know, but Queenslanders just love their cricket, and they loved you just through the years, and how much you gave back to the games, and how much of a legend you were, and how tough you were. And so there are a lot of cricketers who grew up like Simo. In my era, it was Martin Love and Jimmy Marr, and we just looked up to you in such a great way. And for him, he was different, though, even from a really young age, just the flamboyance of the guy.
Oh, just a natural, Carl. You know, he probably would have been good at any sport he took up, but he just had a passion for cricket in particular. I mean, he was keen on his rugby league. Cricket, just a natural, had all the skills, fantastic in the field, you know, batting, swashbuckling, sort of the way he took on the bowlers, bowled some off spin, bowled some medium pace, you know, you could just call on him to do anything. And he did it always with a smile on his face and at 100%, just a real character, great to have around the dressing room. Mm. Yeah, just a wonderful person to have in your cricket team. And yeah, look, we've all been hit very hard in recent times, just very emotional, but yeah, it's just you just got to shake your head. You just wonder why this is happening at the moment. You know, we all lose loved ones at times, but just from a cricketing point of view, it's just been so sad.
Well, when you think, you know, Shane Warne, was 52, Symonds, he was 46, and you just used the word there, you can talk about character. I mean, these are two guys who were larger than life. They're larger than life on the field and they're larger than life off it.
Yeah, so, you know, you just don't expect it. It's just one of those things, you know, it happens to us all, doesn't it, eventually. But, you know, just far too young for that, those sort of characters, special people in our game and around the community, as you talked about with Andrew just before. You know, he's just a wonderful person and put a lot more into life than just meets the eye, you know, going out there and playing cricket. There's a lot more to all the characters that we've lost in recent times that meets the eye, and that's the, you know, the people who know them well know that, you know, it's just a huge loss.
He was a pretty astute reader of other people as well, Simo, from what I knew from a pretty young age. The guy could make a call pretty early on people that would turn out to be right, and was a very straight up dude. AB, I saw Michael Clarke the other day as well. There's a lot that you guys are carrying around at the moment, and a lot of pain that you're carrying around with, because everyone, it's such a tight knit group.
It is, the cricket family is very tight, and you know, when we lose, you know, special people, it hits everyone very hard. And you know, this is no different with Simo. I mean, just you know, just a huge character and just loved by everyone that met him. It's just quite incredible, just the impact he had on everyone who met him, particularly kids. I mean, kids just absolutely adored him. So yeah, it's just hard to comprehend, you know, the way life's been for the cricket family over the last, probably 12 months or more, but just recent times in particular. And this is a big blow, losing Andrew.
We've been hearing over the last couple of days some of the lovely interactions that he's had with kids sort of all over the country. We're thinking of his family, we're thinking of the cricketing community. This morning, AB, you look after yourself.